students, today we will talk about one competitive examination which is known as NTSC. N for national, T for talent, S for search, E for examination. So today we will talk about one competitive examination, NTSC, that is National Talent Search Examination, which contain the syllabus of 9th standard and 10th standard. Which contain the syllabus of 9th standard and 10th standard. Today we'll discuss about the mathematics of NTSC examination. So the syllabus of NTSC mathematics contains algebra, trigonometry, statistics, mean median, mode, then geometry, circle, triangle, congruency, distance formula, coordinate geometry. So today we'll just have a glance of the previous year questions of NTSC maths. So on the board you can see the first question. The value of tan 65 upon cot 25. The value of tan 65 upon cot 25 is, options are A 1, B option is 0, C 1 by 2, D is none of these, means neither 1 nor 0 nor half. None of these means none of the option of A, B, C. So now if you just look at the question, tan and cot, so you have to use the concept of complementary angle. You have to use the concept of complementary angle. And that complementary angle, I have given you the example of Ram Sita. So Ram and Sita, they are complementary of each other. Then Radhe Krishna, Radhe and Krishna, Radha and Krishna, they are complementary of each other. So there is a complementary angle relation between sine and cos, then sec and cosec, complementary angle relation, and tan and cot, tan and cot. So there is a complementary angle relation between sine, cos, sec, cosec, tan, cot. Then sum of the angles sine theta, there is a complementary angle relation between sine and cos. So this I can write cos 90 minus theta. Theta I can replace by 90 minus theta, and complementary of sine is cos. Similarly, cosec 90 minus theta, cosec 90 minus theta, what is complementary of cosec, that is sec, I can write 90 minus theta as theta. Then there is a complementary angle relation between tan and cot, so tan theta I can write cot 90 minus theta, cot 90 minus theta. So there is a complementary angle relation between tan and cot. So tan 65 upon cot 25. So there is a complementary angle relation between tan and cot. Tan and cot. So this tan 65, one you fix, other you change. Either you can fix tan or you can fix cot. But one you fix, other you change. Suppose we are fixing tan 65. So tan 65, we write tan 65. Now there is a complementary angle relation between tan and cot. So cot theta, I can write tan 90 minus theta. That will be 90 minus 25. So that becomes tan 65 upon cot theta, I can write tan 90 minus theta. So that will become tan 65 upon tan 90 minus 25, 65. So 1065 upon 1065 is 1. They get cancelled, answer is 1. So in this we have used the concept of complementary angle. There is a complementary angle relation between tan and cot. So one you fix, other you change. So tan 65 we fix, so cot I can replace by tan 90 minus theta, 90 minus 25. So that will be tan 65 upon tan 65, the answer is 1. So you have to click the correct answer. The correct answer is A. The correct answer is A. 1 is the correct answer. So in NTSC examination, for each mathematics question, you will be given 4 options. And you have to darken or click the correct answer. So first question, 1065 upon cot 25. In this, I have used the concept of complementary angle. There is a complementary angle relation between sine, cos, sec, cosec, tan, cot. And then sum of the angles should be 90. So whenever you come across tan, cot, one you fix, other you change. Okay? Now let us see the second question. So first question was based on complementary angle, trigonometry. Now let us see the second question. Second question, cos 30. Second question, cos 30 degree, cos 30 degree into sin 60 degree into sin 60 degree upon cos 60 degree. So this is the problem of trigonometry. You have to find the value of this. A is 0, B option is 0.5, C option is 1, and D is 1.5. Let us look at this. You can solve by two methods. So this is the problem of trigonometry. So trigonometry, we have studied trigonometric ratios. Then second was trigonometric ratio of standard angle. Standard angles are 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree. So this is 30 degree, 60 degree, 60 degree. So this is the trigonometric ratio of standard angles. And for that standard angle already you have the table. Sin 0, 0, sin 30, 1 by 2, sin 45, 1 by root 2, and sin 60 is root 3 by 2, sin 90 is 1, cos 0, 1, cos 30 is root 3 by 2, cos 45, 1 by root 2, cos 60 is 1 by 2, cos 90 is not defined. Cos 90, sin 90 is cos 90. Clear? Then you have the tan 0, 0, tan 30 is 1 upon root 3. Tan 45 1, tan 60 root 3. So now let us see, cos 30 degree, you have to use the trigonometric ratio of standard angle. So cos 30 degree into sin 60 degree upon cos 60 degree. Use the trigonometric ratio of standard angles. Cos 30 is 1 by 2 into sin 60. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2. Sin 60 is root 3 by 2 upon cos 60. Cos 60 is 1 by 2. So root 3 by 2 into root 3 by 2 is 3 upon 4 upon 1 upon 2. So this will go up, this will come down. So that is 3 into 2 upon 4. So 2 2's are 4, that is 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is 1.5. And here you have the option D, 1.5. Let us see by another way. using the concept of whenever you come across sine cos, you can use the complementary angle. So cos 30 degree into sine 60 degree upon cos 60 degree. So this I can write cos 30 degree into sine 60 degree, then this. So cos 30 degree and cos and sine, there is a complementary angle. So cos 30 degree, let us change sine. Sine 60, I can write cos 90 minus 60, that is 30 degree, upon cos 60. What is cos 30 degree? Cos 30 degree is root 3 by 2. Cos 30 degree is root 3 by 2 upon cos 60 degree. Cos 60 degree is 1 by 2. So that is 3 by 2, 3 by 4 upon 1 by 2. So 2 will go up, 3 into 2 upon 4. 2 2s are 4, that is 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is 1.5. So you can use complementary angle also. So the correct option is 1.5. So this is the problem based on trigonometric ratio of standard angles. For standard angle, there is a table. And if the angle is not standard, you have to use the concept of complementary angle. So for this question, the correct option is 1.5. You have to click the correct answer, 1.5. Then there are the problems from statistics also, mean, median. We have the problem of statistic, that is mean, median. Let us see one problem of NTSC from past year question papers. For individual series, individual series means random numbers are given. For individual series means there is no relation between the given numbers. 108, 64, 107, 54, and 52. Median. Median is A, 52, B, 53, C, 54, and D, 57. So, this is the concept of median, statistic, stats. So, this is the concept of median. So, for median, it is compulsory to arrange the data in either ascending order or descending order first. For median, first you have to arrange the data in ascending order or descending order. So let us arrange the data in ascending order. So 52, 54, 57, 64 and 108. We have arranged the data in ascending order. So, first job is over. For median, it is compulsory to arrange the data in ascending order or descending order. For mean, there is no compulsion of arranging the data in ascending or descending order. For mean, there is no compulsion. But for median, it is compulsory to arrange the data in ascending order or descending order. So, we have arranged the data in ascending order. Then next is, you count how many values are given, n. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. N is 5. 5 is odd. 5 is odd. So whenever data is odd, there is a formula is, median will be n plus 1 upon 2th observation. n plus 1 upon 2th observation. N plus 1 whole divided by 2th observation. So what is n? N is 5. 5 plus 1 upon 2th observation. 5 plus 1 is 6, 6 upon 2, that is third observation. Third observation from left. So median is third observation. Median is not 3. Median is third observation of the data, arranged in ascending order. So which is the third observation? 1, 2, 3. So the median is 57. Median is 57. So for median, it is compulsory to arrange the data in ascending or descending order. Then after that, you have to count the number of values and find n. For n, there are two categories. N is odd and n is even. For n is equal to odd, the median will be n plus 1 upon 2th observation. And for even, what is the formula? That will be n by 2 plus n by 2 plus 1th observation, and you have to divide by 2 for even number of data. And here we have odd number of data, that is 5. So the correct option is 57. You will click over 57, correct option. So this is from statistic. Median. For median, it is compulsory to arrange the data in ascending or descending order. Now let us move to fourth question. So this NTSC mathematics examination, whatever you will study in 9th standard, 10th standard, the problem will come from that concepts only. Now fourth question. Sine 30 degree into tan 60 degree, sine 30 degree into tan 30 degree into cot 30 degree into cosec 60 degree. The value of this is A, tan 30 degree, B, cot 60 degree, C, sine 30 degree into cosec 60 degree, and D is none of these. So let us see. Now in this sine 30, 30 is standard angle, 60 is standard angle. So we can think about the trigonometrical ratios of standard angle. So I am going to use the table. Second thing, the reciprocal of sine, you have to remember along with that. So what is sine theta? What is sine? Opposite upon hypotenuse. Then cos is adjacent upon hypotenuse. Then tan is opposite upon adjacent. Then reciprocal of sine, 1 upon sine is cosec. 1 upon cos is sec. And 1 upon tan is cot. So this you have to remember. We are going to use this concept. Clear? So sine 30 degree. What is sine 30 degree? Sine 30 degree is half. Tan 30 degree is 1 upon root 3. Into cot 30 degree. What is cot 30 degree? Cot is reciprocal of tan. So 1 upon tan 30 degree. 1 upon tan 30 degree. Cot 30 degree I can write 1 upon tan 30 degree. Into cosec. Cosec is reciprocal of sine. So 1 upon sine 60 degree. 1 upon sine 60 degree. Cosec 60 degree I can write 1 upon sine 60 degree. So let us see. 1 upon 2 into 1 upon root 3 into 1 upon tan 30 is 1 by root 3. So 1 upon root 3 So root 3 will go up. 1 upon sin 60. What is sin 60? Sin 60 is root 3 by 2. So 1 upon root 3 by 2. So 2 will go up. So that will be 2 upon root 3. 2 upon root 3. Now you can cancel root 3 with root 3. You can cancel 2 with 2. So what is left everywhere? 1 upon root 3 is left. 1 upon root 3. And what is 1 upon root 3? 1 upon root 3 is nothing but my tan 30 degree. Tan 30 degree is 1 upon root 3. So the correct answer is tan 30 degree. The correct answer is tan 30 degree. So in this I have used the concept of trigonometric ratio of standard angle. Then I have used trigonometric ratio. Sin is opposite upon hypotenuse, cos is adjacent upon hypotenuse, tan is opposite upon adjacent. Then reciprocal of sin, 1 upon sin is cosec, 1 upon cos is sec, 1 upon tan is cot. So in this sin 30 degree, I have put the value from standard table 1 by 2, tan 30 degree 1 by root 3, then cot 30 degree, cot is reciprocal of tan, so 1 upon tan 30 degree. Cosec is reciprocal of sine, 1 upon sine 60 degree. We simplify, we get the answer 1 upon root 3, which is nothing but tan 30 degree. Now let us see the last problem, fifth problem. From algebra. The fifth problem is from algebra. From factorization, from expansion, which you have studied in 9th standard, expansion, factorization, rational number. Now fifth problem, a minus b is 3, if a minus b is 3, correct? And a square minus b square is 117, then a plus b is, options are a 35, b 39, c 9, and d 31. A minus b is given, a square minus b square is given. We have to find the value of a plus b. So this is the problem of expansion which we have studied in 9th standard. We are given the value of a square minus b square. So let us use the formula for a square minus b square. What is a square minus b square? That is a plus b into a minus b. Now out of this, you know the value of a square minus b square, that is 117. A plus b we have to find. Then a minus b is given, a minus b is 3. So 117 upon 3 is equal to a plus b. So 3 is a 9, 11 minus 9 2, 3 9s are 27. So 39 is a plus b. So the value of a plus b is 39. So in which option it is 39? In option b. So you have to click the b option, that is 39. So, this is the problem of expansion. A square minus b square, a plus b into a minus b. Then you can be asked, what is a plus b whole square? Problem based on a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square is a square plus b square plus 2ab. A minus b whole square, a square minus 2ab plus b square. A square minus b square is a plus b into a minus b. You can be asked a cube plus b cube, a plus b whole cube is a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. Is it clear? So, problem of expansion from this formula, based on these formulas, can be asked. You are given a square minus b square 117, a minus b is 3, find the value of a plus b. A square minus b square, the formula is a plus b into a minus b. A square minus b square value is given 117. a plus b, we have to find a minus b is given 3. So this is into 3. So 3 is in the multiplication. On left hand side, it will go in the division. So a plus b is 117 upon 3, that is 39. So b is the correct option.
So students, NTSC mathematics questions are based on the syllabus of 9th standard and 10th standard. So start preparation of NTSC from 9th standard itself. And whatever concept you will learn in 9th standard and 10th standard, based on those concepts, the syllabus of NTSC is formed. So NTSC, you are not going to get anything new. Only the thing is, you should be thorough with the concept, well prepared with the formula, and you have to be fully concentrated. You have to put full concentration in solving the problem. That's all. So nothing is difficult. You should be confident about cracking the examination of NTSC, National Talent Search Examination, whose form you will fill next year, means 10th standard. And thoroughly you have to study the syllabus of 9th standard, 10th standard. There is mathematics also, there is science also, other subjects also. But we will talk about mathematics. So in this period, I had solved 5 problems. Next period will cover the remaining problems. Next 5. So every period there will be 5 problems, and those 5 problems we will discuss. So try to solve, try to make thorough all the formulas, list all the formulas, revise it. There should not be confusion at all. You have to remember the trigonometric ratio of standard angle table, then complementary angle, then Pythagoras theorem, triangle, circle, coordinate geometry, distance formula, circle, diameter, concept of diameter, arc. Yes, now we stop here. Okay, see you. See all of you. Have a nice day.